No, I've never used steroids. Yes, I'm on testosterone replacement therapy. If you don't understand the difference, please start by watching this video all about TRT. As a matter of fact, before you ask any questions on this video, please watch the video all about TRT. I will answer all the questions that you ask on this video. It's one of the advantages of having a smaller channel now. I can answer all your questions personally. But if you ask a question that's answered in that video, I'm going to just post a link to it. Before we get started, we're going to play a little guessing game, and you're going to understand why in about 60 seconds. Here is my physique history in the last 35 years. When do you think I started using TRT? The reason we're playing this guessing game is a lot of you have the mistaken idea that when a doctor puts you on testosterone replacement therapy, you gain all kinds of muscle. So when do you think I started TRT? You can kind of tell here that my peak muscularity was in 2001. So when do you think I started using TRT? Okay, another hint. In 2016, between these two photos and my physique history, my testosterone level was 119. That's off the chart on the low end. Normal is 250 to 827. I was way below that in 2016. That's not what you were suspecting, was it? You were going to guess that I started like a couple years before 2001. No, that's for natty gains. Huh, I was right. You're a cheater. Let me follow this. So I started testosterone replacement therapy that my doctor put me on to lose muscle mass, and that makes me a cheater. Okay? What point exactly are you trying to make? Yes, going on testosterone replacement therapy decreases your muscle loss, but still you can tell. I have continued to lose muscle since 2001 and continued up to this day. So again, please watch the All About TRT, because putting your testosterone levels back into the normal range will only build muscle if you are a complete newbie. If you're someone like me who is after genetic match, it just slows the decline. There have been a lot of really high-profile cases of athletes who have used the excuse of they're on TRT for reasons that their testosterone levels were sky high. When you abuse TRT, it's no different than doing steroids. But that is not TRT. That's steroid use. So, should you do TRT? A lot of people in the comments section are going to ask that. TRT is not like a nose job. It's not something you go to the doctor and ask for. If you were to go to the doctor and ask to be put on TRT for muscle gain, they would tell you exactly the same thing as if you went in and asked for steroid. They would give you a stern lecture, spin you around, and kick you out the door so fast your head would spin. Because it's illegal and unethical. They cannot prescribe TRT for muscle gain. That is steroid use. At this point, some of you are going to tell us about a friend of a friend who went to a longevity clinic to get a prescription for TRT. That's true. These places do exist, but they get shut down really fast.
Yum, yum.
And if the doctors have medical licenses at all, they're going to lose them. This is not legal. They fake the test results to give you the prescription. It's expensive and legally dangerous. So, should you use TRT? No, you don't use TRT. Testosterone replacement therapy is something you're put on. It doesn't come out of a TRT bottle. And should you do it? Ask your doctor. No one other than your doctor is qualified to, one, determine if you are low in testosterone, and two, determine if the symptoms you have warrant the risk associated with TRT, which involves medical history and your current health. Only your doctor can make that call. Please do not use Google to ask if you should do TRT. Would you Google to see if you should have open heart surgery or not? I hope not. Why did you take so long to tell us? You deceived us. Interesting question. So probably 10 times a day, I get people asking, are you on TRT? I kind of crack up because Google has the answer. If you Google, is Scooby on TRT?
You want some spinach? Ooh, I want some spinach.
Page one, line one, is a link to my page that tells you everything here. It's not a big secret. When people ask this question on YouTube, I link them to my page all about TRT because it's completely clear from their question. The main problem is they have no idea what TRT is, what it's for, what it does. I've been around since the sunrise of the internet, so let me tell you exactly what's going to happen here. When bodybuilding.com, Reddit, or Natty or not get a hold of this, there's going to be all kinds of posts that say, I knew it, Scooby is a cheat and a liar. He got his physique from TRT. I can't force these people to use the space between the ears. Despite me laying this out very carefully and concisely, all these people are going to see is, Scooby does TRT! I feel really sorry for these people who are so lazy, undisciplined, and entitled, they cannot grasp the fact that the reason I am in better shape than them is that I've been working at fitness and health for 35 years, lifting consistently week after week, doing 5 to 15 hours cardio a week, eating clean nutrition from unprocessed or minimally processed foods, getting 8 hours sleep. The truth is too tough for them to grasp. The reason I chose to do this video is there is so much misinformation in the bodybuilding community about what TRT is and what it does. I knew that by doing this video, all kinds of negative publicity would be headed my way, and 99% people will laugh and call me a cheater without turning on their brains. The reason I'm doing this is for the 1% of people that this video will actually help. A few people will watch my video all about TRT so that in the future, if their testosterone levels drop, causing them medical problems, that they will be better informed to have an informed discussion with their doctor about the pros and cons of doing TRT. What exactly does 100% natty mean?
Eat spinach. Nom 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 nom.
Anyone who goes around screaming 100% natty is not. On YouTube, Instagram, and in men's physique contests, 100% natty means sensible cycles, whatever that means. The definition of natural is something that powerlifting federations and Olympic committees grapple with all the time. Is insulin for diabetics natural? What about TRT? What ranges are acceptable? What about trans people? It gets stickier and stickier. What is natural? You're going to have to decide for yourself what natural means to you. I honestly don't care what category you put me into. One thing that's perfectly clear, where there's money to be made, there are cheaters. The universal rule. And there is a lot of money to be made in professional athletics, from the Olympics to cage fighting to pro football. I personally have a pretty easy test.
Okay, we're almost done here. I'll be starting the live broadcast. In the meantime, go ahead and ask your questions and I'll reply to them.
In my book, if the medication is taken to improve their health, they're still natty. If it's taken for any other reason, they're not natty. Pretty simple in my book. Thanks for watching. Healthy your day.
Okay, let's turn this puppy around. How do I do that? Hold on. Okay, now we're really live and I can answer your questions. Hold on a sec, let me shut this down. Okay, the first question is, when did I start to lose muscle mass? Well, if you look at my 35-year physique history, it's pretty apparent that 2001 was my peak muscularity. Ever since then, I've been slowly losing muscle mass. But one thing I've done to mask that is you'll notice from my physique history that after 2001, I focused much more on getting lean and ripped because it's a great optical illusion. When you're really lean, it makes you look a lot more muscular than you are. Let me see if I can grab that photo. Hold on. Because that's a good question. Where'd that go? Oh, I lost it. Anyway, let's get into more questions here. Let's see. Sorry. Okay, let's see. Is TRT the same thing as juicing? Please either read my page all about TRT or watch the video all about TRT, because it is not. And that is one of the main purposes of me doing these videos. And clearly I have failed because some people still have not grasped the most important message, which is TRT is a replacement therapy, whereas anabolic steroid usage is when you put your testosterone levels at 5, 10, 20 times what is normal. And it makes your skin turn purple, you get acne, a big mess. Now, someone is gonna laugh right about now and say, "What? Your skin's purple." I have what you call cumulative sun damage. I had great skin till I was about 52. And then all of a sudden in 1 year, it started turning red and blotchy, and I went to the dermatologist thinking it was just a fungus or something. And I was told that, too bad, it was 3 decades of constant sun exposure that damaged my skin. So it's always red now, even though I always use SPF 30 reapplied every hour when I was outside. Okay, let's get some more questions here. How old am I now? I always round up. I say I'm 60, but I was born in 1961. Let's see. Hold on, I have to. Am I making sure to keep estrogen in check just in case? I've heard that even TRT can cause a bump in estrogen. I would disagree on that. I would say if you're a MMA fighter who is pretending to do TRT but has levels like 10 times normal, yeah, you need estrogen then, because it's not TRT you're doing, it's anabolic steroid use, and then you have to deal with estrogen. But really, when your testosterone levels are in the normal range, it's no different than if your body produced it itself. You're no more in need of estrogen therapy on legitimate TRT as you are if you just have normal testosterone. Diabolus Musica says MM fighters have to do a test to make sure they're in the normal range. You know what? Where there's money, there are cheaters. And the more money, the more the cheating. There is not a drug test on the planet that someone with enough money and resources behind them cannot defeat. It's a reason why in the Olympics, so many athletes get busted after the fact. But a lot of them, it takes 10 years. I mean, look at, I'm blanking on his name. But anyway, the cheaters are about a decade ahead of the testing authorities. So just because they test means absolutely nothing. Those MM fighters, they just, you know, stop a couple days before the test. Let's see, let's get some more. Do you use the cream, and if so, do you feel it works up? Well, first of all, when you start testosterone replacement therapy, it's pretty much a life commitment, because if your testosterone has gone down, it indicates something is not functioning normally, and it's very unlikely that it will ever start back up. That's something to definitely consider on TRT, in addition to the health consequences, is the cost. Even with really good insurance, the good testosterone replacement products, which I consider to be the gels, because it's it very closely mimics your daily testosterone cycle in of normal males, whereas the injections, it goes whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. So the gels are really expensive, even with good insurance. I mean, thousands of dollars a year. So it's something to consider. Do you want to commit to something that's going to be thousands of dollars a year for the rest of your life? That was a good question. Let's see. Yes, Diabolicus Musica says, everyone's testosterone levels goes down when they get older. I have, never say never, but I've never heard of a case where someone's testosterone increases as they get older. Perhaps in some version of cancer it might, but that's not something you would wish for. Miki Lopa says, how do I pick up girls? Well, one hand, of course. Let's see, hold on, let me grab this question. It keeps moving. Okay, here's a question. Hold on a sec. Runny nose. Mike asks, are you concerned about the possibility that TRT may expose you to a higher prostate cancer risk? Are you doing anything regarding surveillance? So that's a really good point. When you go on testosterone replacement therapy with your doctor, it's not like he gives you a prescription and you just disappear for a decade. There's certain things that they do every year to make sure that no problems are developing. And there's a lab test that they do to check for prostate issues, and also in a yearly exam, they check for those. That is part, that's exactly why TRT is not something you go to the drugstore and buy over the counter, because it's simply not safe for people to use on their own, not to mention the fact that they probably abuse it. So that was a really good question. Okay, does TRT require a special diet to be effective? Does being healthy require a special diet? Yes, you have to eat clean. You have to avoid processed foods and junk foods. The TRT raises your testosterone. That's completely independent from your nutrition. If your diet is crap on nutrition, you're going to have crappy health, regardless of whether you do TRT or not. Hey, it's Superpunks from Sweat for Health. Wait, let me see what his question was. Where was it? I can't find him. Hold on. Where's We're super punks. Oh, I lost his question. Where is it? I'm sorry, super punks. I saw your question, but it scrolled by before I could get it. Sorry about that. Okay, let's see. My thoughts on stem cell therapy. I think that it holds great hope. Right now, there's not a lot one can do with it. Yes, Jeff Side is my son. Let's see. Sorry, I'm having trouble. The comments scroll by rather quickly here. Okay, this is not related, but what's my favorite exercise for deltoids? You know, first of all, a lot of you know I'm retiring New Year's Eve from YouTube. I won't be doing any more YouTube videos on a regular basis. I'm gonna shut down my Facebook page. But one thing I'm gonna continue to do is I love my fitness tools, the meal planner, doing the blog posts, doing research, doing writing, increasing my content there. Now, one thing I need to cover before the end of the year is the subject of working out when you're older and things you can do when you're younger to prevent shoulder issues and knee issues. Because I have 3 decades worth of experience and mistakes on that. So I'll be answering that. One thing I wanted to tell you people, Super Punks reminded me, he's a former Sweat for Health member. So I'm definitely keeping the Sweat for Health forum, and that is the best place if you have questions for me after January 1st. Now, there's a discount code. I just increases the prices at Sweat for Health, but there's a 50% discount code that you can use to join until January 1st. And it says it's only for friends and family, but I'm giving you permission. You are my friend, so you can use that 50% off coupon. After January 1st, it goes away, so there'll be a 100% price increase January 1st. Okay, let's... Scoob Tube, I love that. Let's see. Fake name, do you cycle TRT? Absolutely not. You cycle steroids. TRT mimics what your body should do naturally, which is every day it's a curve. It's like at night your TRT drops and then it goes up in the morning through the day and it drops. So TRT keeps you on this curve without variation. You don't cycle it. Let's see. Have I ever dealt with sleep apnea? No, but that's a very serious issue. They now make, it used to be you had to go to sleep clinics to get that diagnosed. Now they have monitors that you can just take home with you. Sleep apnea is serious because it can mess up your gains completely, muscular gains, and it can cause fat gain. So you don't want that. Let's see. Good workouts for people with cerebral palsy. Sorry, I have no idea. I am not a medical professional. You need to deal with a physical therapist if you're in the US or a physiotherapist if you're in Europe. Let's see. Are there any lifestyle changes to help testosterone loss you would recommend? Okay, this is a great question. It's a huge market. If you go to bodybuilding.com and Google testosterone boosters, you'll find dozens of really expensive products, and they're all 100% useless. Do not waste your money. As far as lifestyle changes, yes, sleep. You need, the more sleep you get, the more testosterone you're going to produce. Also, lifting heavy helps you increase testosterone. The big exercises. If you can't do squats, do leg press. It's when you're moving a bunch of weight is when your testosterone goes up. But seriously, the most important thing is sleep. And you know, clean nutrition doesn't help. I didn't get a chance to finish this. This is my, I'm on a Meal Planet custom meal planner now. This is the Hulk Scramble. It is nummy, a pound of spinach with about 70 grams of protein and a little guacamole or avocado, sorry. Let's see. Somebody needs to watch the video again. Stop answering questions and eat the spinach. Good idea. Thank you for that. Hold on. Just had to ban someone for asking stupid questions about a gay doctor. Okay, here's a question, and I'm going to tell you why I'm not going to answer it. A lot of people have been asking, so this is Hunter asked, why did you need TRT in the first place? Did it help? And other people asking, you know, what were your symptoms? I'm not going to answer that for two reasons. First, because if I know you probably have pure motives, but someone watching this video in a week or two is going to say, you know, oh, Scooby said this and he went to his doctor and he got TRT. I want to do that too. So I'm going to tell my doctor that. I don't want to feed people lines to tell their doctor. The other reason is it doesn't matter. If you have medical problems, go to your doctor. I had medical problems, so I went to my doctor. It's pretty simple. On another line here, I'm a firm believer in having a good relationship with your doctor. I believe that a yearly visit to the doctor is a good thing so that you can check in with the doctor, even if you're not sure you have anything, just to have them check things out, make sure everything's okay. Like just last week, I went to my doctor and we had a good little chat about bee stings because, you know, I get stung in the face a lot and there's a photo of me on the internet with my eye like swollen shut. It's pretty disgusting from a wasp thing. And I was wondering if that's any health danger. Like, you know, if it stung me in the neck, would I stop breathing because my airway would swell shut? And I had a good discussion with him about that. That's not something you should Google on the internet. There's certain things you should ask your doctor. And the short answer of that is, no, that's not a systemic reaction to the bee venom. It's a localized. And localized issues are not a problem. So an EpiPen does nothing when my eyes swell shut. It's just ice packs. Okay, sorry about the distraction there. Let's get some more of your questions here. Mark, I'm a front end web designer and I'd love to hear you talk more about your software like Custom Meal Planner. Evie, give that a thought. You know, I love doing it, but one thing you'll notice since you're a front-end web developer is that I don't really care about the way it looks. I am all about giving people meal plans inexpensively as quickly as possible. And I don't spend one extra second to make the website pretty. So I'm sure you've noticed that. Like, I'm one person, I do everything. I can't make everything pretty. Life changer, what do you think about doing daily push-ups? Tell me your goal and I'll tell you what I think about doing daily push-ups. How to lift with HIV. That is a great discussion to have with your doctor to if there's any limitations you have because of your HIV status. Depending on where you are in your treatment, I imagine it could range from absolutely no limitations at all to, you know, don't do it. But I would just be guessing. Talk to your doctor. Harristown, do you think more cities should make calisthenic parks? Yes, I think those are awesome. I think not only is it great to give people a place to work out, but I think it helps motivate people walking by. It's like, you know, they see someone doing muscle ups and it's like, well, maybe I'm gonna try to do my first pull up. I think they're awesome. And I think it would be a great investment in America if we put more money into making people fit instead of on the back end paying 1,000 times that for all the obesity medicines and open heart surgery. It's like a penny of prevention is worth a pound of cure. Elect me in 2020 and I will make it happen. No, please don't. Let's see, let's do another question here. Let's see. Greetings from Chile. Oh, sorry about your economic and social unrest there. That sounds like a big old mess. Someone said Scooby Ben injecting Band-Aid. If you notice. Yes, well, actually I didn't do it myself. That is the shingles vaccine. When I was a kid, I had chicken pox really, really bad. They were really concerned about me. So the new shingles vaccine came out. And because I had such a horrible time with the chicken pox, I thought it was important that I get the shingles. So that was my second injection for the shingles. If you've had chicken pox, you might want to consider getting the shingles vaccine because it's not something you want. Okay, life changer. So life changer earlier asked a question, what do you think about doing push-ups in every day? And I asked him what his goal was. My goal is endurance and thinking about doing daily push-ups and not going to failure. Well, if your goal is to do daily push-ups, then doing daily push-ups is the way to accomplish that goal. What I was getting at is, if your goal is to add lots of muscle mass, daily push-ups are not going to do it. If your goal is to enter a powerlifting competition and you really need a lot of bench press strength, daily push-ups is not going to do it. All daily push-ups make you do is get better at doing daily push-ups. The communist says, how does someone gain the willpower to get back on a diet and workout program? Figure out your motivation. Why are you doing it? Clearly you haven't figured that out because you're not motivated. I work out because it makes me feel good. Someone was incredulous when I said that I do 5 to 15 hours of cardio a week. And he said, God, I can't imagine doing that. Why don't you just eat less? Because I like doing cardio. I love riding my bike up in the mountains. It's part of the reason my stress levels are so low, is there's nothing like getting outdoors in the woods, away from everything. Okay, let's get some more questions here. Do you support MMA training? I don't understand the question, sorry. CJ says, trying to bulk, having issues getting enough carbs per the recommended amount. Whose recommended amount? Okay, first of all, bulking is only appropriate for people who are very advanced and close to their genetic max. If you're a newbie or intermediate, you're not going to gain anything by bulking, in my opinion. If you do want to bulk, please go to Custom Meal Planner and select the bulking meal plan and select a 5% or a 10% caloric surplus. That is what I recommend. Okay, someone asked, is TRT appropriate for a teen who's having trouble growing? Absolutely not. Rule number one, go to your doctor. It's not going to make you taller. It's not going to make you stronger or bigger. As a teen, you're rolling in hormones. Adding more is not going to help. If you want to gain muscle, first of all, you need to have realistic expectations. My bet is that you just have very unrealistic expectations about how quickly you should be able to gain muscle. Please go to my website and do search on expectations, or you can Google muscle gain expectation calculator and find an appropriate goal. Let's see. I take it a win that we have so few questions on TRT. That is awesome. Dark Satan wants to thank me for being awesome. You're quite welcome. Avoid the dark matter, yes. Let's see. Okay, here's a question. What's your opinion on changing gym training with weights and machines to calisthenics in the park? It's two different things. I think that the calisthenics stuff is really, really cool. It's more like gymnastics. It's more about coordination and balance and doing really cool stuff. It's not optimal for gaining muscle mass. It's not optimal for gaining strength. I think a good, well-rounded workout would have you doing both. You know, if you did two weight workouts a week and one bar workout, I think that would be a great combination. Gustavo says, custom meal planner question. Can you eat snacks or what can you drink? It only shows the meals. You can only consume what is in the meal plan. As to drink, you get water. As far as snacks, in the simple mode, you just get the meals. If you want a snack, you can take part of a meal and have it later. So, for example, a lot of times, a lunch will have an apple. So have the apple 2 hours after your lunch as a snack. But you can only eat what's on the planner. Now, if you put it into advanced mode, it lets you design your own meal plan, and you can put all the snacks in you want. So you could have, you know, put in a pre-workout shake with an apple and a post-workout shake with a banana, whatever you want. But no, if you do the free meal plans at Custom Meal Planner, you can only eat and drink what is on the plan. And since it doesn't specify anything to drink, you drink water. Good question. Okay, here's an interesting question. I've never heard it phrased exactly this way. What's your opinion of red meat in building muscle? First of all, I think it's pretty clear that I do not put up with vegan bullshit. On the other hand, I'm a firm believer in the benefits of plant-based nutrition, or is getting as many of your calories as possible from plants. Now, as far as beef itself, beef is actually not that great a source of protein. First of all, the protein quality in beef is nowhere near as high as chicken, fish, and none of those meats are anywhere close to the quality of eggs and dairy. So red meat, the protein quality is bad. Well, not bad. It's just not great. It's better than a bean, but it's not as good as egg whites. The other issue with beef is a lot of times there's a lot of fat in it. So if you look at the percent of protein by calories, it's only like 50% because the fat makes it high calories. And that may not be a problem if you're bulking, but if you're cutting, you just cannot get enough protein from beef because there's so much fat in it. Good question. My thought on fitness trackers like Fitbit. I think it's really good for people who are very unhealthy and very out of shape to help motivate them to walk. Because for people who don't go to the gym and don't take care of themselves, walking 20 to 30 minutes a day is the best thing they can do for their health. Now, you people, on the other hand, you're athletes. You go to the gym. You're very active. For you, you might as well be counting finger reps. It's like, this is not exercise. The number of steps you take walking is nothing. It's running steps you should be counting. So I consider them useless for athletes. Interesting question. Did any of your family get drafted to Vietnam back in the 60s? A lot of you don't realize this, but it wasn't too long ago when there was a part of the government called the Selective Service. And people of between the ages of, I can't remember, 16 and 21, 18 and 21, were needed to register their name and address with the U.S. Post Office so that they could be drafted. And there was actually, so when I was a junior and senior in high school, that was a requirement. So thank God I didn't get drafted, but yes, I was required to inform the Selective Service of my address. Good random question. Yes, I am going to visit my special friends. I actually plan on having a special broadcast where I'll be answering their questions, and you will know when it is time. I will make myself known. Because I have to say, I had some great times with my special friends. There were some amazingly witty, intelligent, funny people there. I treasure the time I spent there. Let's see. Okay. Do you recommend working with free weights or machines more? Tell me your goals and tell me your limitations, and then I can answer that question. You can't answer that question in general. Am I still gay? Yep. Is it possible to get lower body gains using a treadmill incline? Yes and no. You're never going to have tree stump quads, but things like running and biking do build your quads. Because of my knee issues, I haven't been able to do that much heavy lifting. So a lot of my leg workouts have been, you know, the 2 hour biking up the mountain, standing on the pedals the whole way because it's so steep. It's kind of like leg press for 2 hours straight. So yes, you can, but you're not going to have huge quads ever. Someone asked, do you still have and use the Kurt Kinetic Bite Trainer? Yes, I love that. I only use it when the weather is really horrible because I hate stationary bikes, but the Kurt Kinetic Trainer is amazing. For those of you that don't know, the magnetic resistant ones are sucky. They don't provide enough resistance. The Kurt Kinetic Trainer uses a hydraulic system, and basically the faster you go, the harder it is. Even a Tour de France cyclist couldn't beat this machine. I have the old one. The new one is smart, where it lets it vary the resistance so you can do things like Swift, where it simulates different courses. So yeah, the Kurt Kinetic Trainer is a great piece of equipment. Is Hans gay? You know what? I think so, because he spends all his time up there on the shelf with the other gay guys. Oh, I have to show you this, by the way. Someone was asking about him. He's from Sweden. Yes, he still stays on my shelf back there with Hans. Hyper from Germany is 51 years old. Curious how I cope with getting older physically and mentally. You know what? It's interesting. Because it happens so slowly, the deterioration, it's really easy to cope with. You know, if I was 18 years old and woke up the next day 60, it would be so depressing I'd probably want to commit suicide. But because it's happened so slowly, you know, the fact that the first hour of the day my back hurts so much that I can't do anything, I can't even put on my shoes, it's like, meh, it's just the way it is. But it's just adaptation. With the workouts, I do what I can. I can't always do all the exercises. You know, when you're 18, you can do all 800 exercises in Arnold's Encyclopedia of Bodybuilding. By the time you're 60, you can do like 20 of them. It's like you just do what you can. Okay, we have 3 more minutes. And then my husband's home. So I'm going to get some more questions in. What country have you visited that had the most culture shock? Mine was China. I think probably the biggest one was when I went to Vietnam. It's an experience in the big cities. Crossing the street by having to close your eyes and just hope all the motorbikes go around you. That's a trip. Let's see. Hold on, please. Gotta make this guy go away. Is golf a real sport? Discuss. Felix asks, will I do more woodworking videos? Probably not. I'm trying to do 2 to 3 videos a week, but I've got some really important topics to discuss, and I don't think there's room for a woodworking one. But, you know, after January 1st, I'll still do videos now and then. They just won't be fitness-related or investment advice or life advice-related. It'll just be me having fun. So I might still do videos. Again, and people have asked how they can get in touch with me. After January 1st, my YouTube videos, the comments will be turned off. You'll still be able to see the old comments, but you won't be able to make new ones. My Facebook page is being shut down. Instagram, I'll keep on. If you want to find out where I'm doing meet and greets, check the blog on Scooby's Workshop. I plan on keeping that up, doing a weekly, at least, blog post there. And then also, if you're interested in getting some coaching one-on-one, you can join Sweat for Health. Again, I mentioned this. Until the end of the year, there's 50% off. You're free to use the friends code that's there. The reason I put it there is I doubled the fees for the forum, and I felt guilty about not giving people notice. So that's why I did a 50% off code. So it's basically the same price. I mean, I'm not pretending, but that code will go away on January 1st, and the price increase will take effect. So you can contact me there. So one more question, then I'm going to reheat my Hulk scramble, which is spinach with egg whites and avocado, and eat it up. Okay, let's get another question here. One more. Yes, okay, it's 6 o'clock. I can still do it. Are my pecs getting smaller? Probably. I mean, all of me is getting smaller slowly year by year. Which is my favorite hat? The black and white houndstooth one, no question. But for cardio in the summer, this is the one I always wear because it's cotton, very absorbent. This can hold like a gallon of sweat. It's pretty impressive. When am I coming to Ireland? There's a chance, not this summer, but next summer. Again, look on Scooby's Workshop. Let's see. Okay. Okay, one more question. One more, and then I gotta go. Really. I really gotta go. Okay, hold on. Okay, let me choose the question. Okay, let's see. Scooby, do you spend a fortune on sunblock? No, because I stopped using any form of sunblock because that's what got me in the problem in the first place. Because even with SPF 30 or 48, enough gets through that if you're out in the sun all day, that is too much. So I do not use sunscreen anymore. What I use is the Under Armour compression shirts, you know, that go all the way to the wrist and the neck. And I wear those all the time. If I do a video and you see my shirt off, it's either because I'm in the shade or because it's after 5 p.m. or before 8 a.m. or my shirt is just off for the 30 seconds I film. Okay, you can tell Milo is ready for a walk. Thanks for watching. Until next time, Auf Wiedersehen.